Okay, I'm out here on the line, checking these sets. See what I got. Got this EP here on the right that basically it's just been feeding the mice. And I think today fed them again. Yeah, well, I ended up putting a big marshmallow. And by the looks of it, you can see they were able just to eat the top of the marshmallow. Bottom half of the marshmallow is still in there. Then I came over here and I ended up putting another DP and a foothold on this trail here. You can see over there, there's the DP with the marshmallow sticking out of it. And then obviously there's nothing in it. And I ended up putting a foothold base of that tree right there. Nothing in that one. And I've got this DP here, which the bait hasn't been touched all week. By the looks of it, since there's so many mice around here, seems like there's not much activity on this side. But you just really never know where these guys are at. Unless you find, you know, you find signs, like tracks. Nothing there. That DP right there, I ended up putting a bigger marshmallow on the trigger. Then put some dog food in it and topped it off with a marshmallow. That way, you know, it's nice and visible. And nothing in this set. All right, let's keep moving down the line. Okay, a little further down the line, I've got two DPs and two footholds here. First DP is right here. I ended up putting a bigger marshmallow on the trigger and put dog food in it and a big marshmallow on the top. Then I got these two footholds right across from each other. Nothing in it. And this other DP right there. Now, this is day three where I'm checking my sets and nothing in it at all. Besides the mice eating the bait on the one DP. But yeah, it's just the name of the game. You know, check my sets basically every morning since the critters usually move around at night. But let's keep going down the line, see what happens. Hey, This is a new location. I came in, put a couple traps. I'm gonna put in this DP right here. And as you can see, some a-holes came and just dumped some tires here. Obviously, a racer, since they're low profile tires. Stupid assholes messing up our woods. But what can you do? I ended up putting that DP there in the entrance, and I put like a step down dirt hole set right here, base of this tree. Then I ended up making this set, and right next to it, I ended up making another step down dirt hole set. The one thing I like about the step down dirt hole set is that basically when they're gonna step down, they have to be completely committed to going down into that hole. And once they take that step into it, basically they're stepping right on top of the pan. And you know, that's when I get them. But as you can see, nothing in these sets. So let's keep going down the line. Okay, back out here. Checking the last few sets I have out. Let's see what I got. Got that cubby set right there with that skunk buried under there. And as you can see, nothing has came to eat it. Then got this DP right here, which I sure rebate with a bigger marshmallow, because I only had the little marshmallows. Then I got this foothold right there. Then the foothold right across from it. Nothing in that one. Well, for that trap I have up there, this is basically what I've been waiting for. I've been waiting for it to rain and wash off the skunk essence. Can't see nothing in that DP. There goes the trap as I left it. This is what I've been waiting for it to rain and you know, neutralize that essence, and nothing in that set. Let me keep going down the line. Okay, I'm a bit further down the line. Let's see what I got in these two sets over here. Over here, I only have the two sets right across from each other. Second time I see them there. That might be a prime location to set up my tree stand. Because obviously they really like growing over there. Obviously nothing in this set, because I would have had something, definitely would have seen it moving. Well, basically this is what I wanted to show, that, you know, many people think that trapping is easy, but it's not. You know, you have to put a lot of work, a lot of dedication into it. You know, you basically have to check your sets on a daily basis. Any set that gets disturbed or gets tripped and doesn't get a catch, basically you have to reset it, and then you have to do scouting during the year to see which locations are prime for you know, for activity, and you know, just taking all the equipment and gathering all the equipment to actually trap. You know, it takes a lot of work and a lot of money, but yeah, that's just the name of the game. You know, some days you catch something and some days you just don't catch anything at all. But, you know, me, I take a lot of pleasure out of just being out here in the woods. You know, when I'm out here in the woods, it's just so relaxing, and, you know, I just forget about the world, you know? You know? Just how it is. Whatever you like to do, just do it. It's just how it is. All right, thank you for watching.